Alright, I'm gonna do this dungeon now, the second one. So unless I'm really missing something, I don't think I really had any other choice but to do this dungeon. Like, everywhere I looked, I needed either the hookshot or the bigger glove, whatever the next one was. I think I get the hook shot in this this dungeon. Oh yeah, this is definitely the shot. Interesting. I never noticed that before. That attacks when you attack. Thank you. I know, I seem to remember there was one spot where you can push through. I guess I need to go down the right. Okay, this isn't the right way. I haven't gone south here yet. Thank you. Alright, I'm kind of lost again. That was causing problems. I thought I got to a spot there where those were just in the wrong state. If I just go around up here and then fall down on the right side, I'll get to a spot where the red things should be down now. Yes, okay, this is it. And then there'll be a key in here, the big key. Now I just head back to that main room and I will be able to get the hookshot. Wow, those guys do 2 hearts per hit, I think. Well, it's pretty close to the entrance. Yeah, I'm not sure which is the best way to go. I think maybe this. Okay. I'd hope that would give me some. It's the wrong way. I guess this must open both doors. Okay, good. Okay, yeah, it must be one of these has a hidden door in it. I guess, I don't know, the next Zelda game that came out was Four Swords. That's one I never bought as a kid. I didn't have it. I guess that was Game Boy Advance. I think because, I don't know, I didn't really have any other, you know, friends that lived nearby that I would, you know, play with, you know, that had the Game Boy Advance. I had some other friends that were on the road, but they didn't have a Game Boy Advance, and, you know, my friends at school that I saw, it was kind of hard to organize, you know, long, Zelda, you know, multiplayer Zelda games with them, so I never ended up getting it. I didn't see the point in, you know, getting it just for, Link to the Past. But a few years ago, I did play through it just by myself on an emulator, just controlling two separate Links. So I had like the left stick would do one like green Link, and the right stick would do red Link, and you know different buttons for each of them, which was pretty interesting. I think that would be kind of a cool, I don't know, game mechanic. If someone was to make like a full game out of it, like, you know, have it actually intending that one person controls both characters. Because, you know, it's too difficult to just have them do completely different things, but if you have them do the exact same thing, or like a mirror, like they both go in like opposite direction circles or something, then I found that was doable. So it'd be neat to see an entire game kind of based around that, around, you know, figuring out how to control the two characters at the same time. I like bosses like this. I wish there was more bosses where you just, you know, slowly pick them apart. So yeah, that was fun to do that, you know, play the... You know, finally play through it and, you know, just by myself. I don't think I ever did the GameCube one. I don't remember, I think it's maybe a bit different with how its multiplayer worked. I don't remember if everybody needs, like, a Game Boy Advance and a Link cable, like in, Crystal Chronicles. Kill me. It's a little bit of a trek back here from the entrance. Yeah, so I don't know, not much else to say about Four Swords. You know, playing it by myself, it was, you know, interesting doing it that way. I still prefer the actual kind of single, like, story, I don't know, adventure, rather than, I don't know if those are randomly generated, but it's a lot more, kind of, you know, loose with the, I don't know, the world or whatever. Shot now, so I think that would let me get up there now, maybe. Or I think I need the glove actually to get up to that dungeon. I could cross there and then I can get to Kakariko again, Dark World Kakariko. I think I could also cross there, in the Light World, anyways. But I do have access to most of the rest of the map now. Alright, I guess I'm gonna kind of stop playing for today. And I'll be heading to Kakariko and Dungeon 3, I guess, tomorrow.